What's up, you guys? Joker back. Sorry, it's been a while since my last video, but I've been very distracted lately, but I thought it's time to release a new one, so here I am, and today we're taking a look at my belt setup, why I have these pouches the way I do, and kind of their function, so we'll go into details with this. Hopefully you'll enjoy this video, so we'll start off right off the bat here. On the left side, we have two Emerald pouches, elastic magazine pouches. These work with VAL magazines or just more or less any kind of AK standard magazine. These also works for 45 rounds, but they're not very comfortable to have in, so it's better if you just have the normal 30 rounds magazines, so to speak. So I have two here. Reason why I have them on my left hip is I'm a right shooter, and when I was in the military, I was always trained to work with my left hand, always keep the weapon in control. So preferably, if I need to make a fast reload and I don't have time to fibble about in my vest, because usually all of my magazines are located on the chest area if I'm wearing a chest rig or body armor, it's easy to just grab a magazine on your hip with these elastic pouches. So it's very quick retrieval, as you can see. Putting them back in is a little bit slower, however. Now, so we have these two here. Next one is a pistol magazine pouch, I would say. I'm not specifically sure that's the purpose of it, but it works. And I have an extra magazine here for my sidearm, which we'll be looking at very shortly. And also, like I said, it's on the left since I work with my left hand. So when I'm reloading, I'll drop it in the dump pouch, just open this up, grab one of these, reload. Pretty easy. It's just one extra mag. Hopefully I don't get to spend more than two magazines. That sounds like an intense firefight in that case. Next is a dump pouch from also from Fort. It's in the Emerald camouflage like the other ones you'll see here. Doesn't look very nice maybe, but it's very easily just rolled up, and if you need to use it, just pull this and it extends out, and you can fit actually a surprising amount of magazines in this pouch. It looks small, but it definitely works. Also, this is also on the left side because I work with my left hand when reloading and such activities. So when I take out a magazine, I just drop it on the left side in this dump pouch. Middle pouch is actually a gas mask pouch. Why I have this here is because if you look at pictures from FSB operators nowadays using belts, you'll see that they most likely always have one bigger pouch. It could be a smaller backpack or just a gas mask pouch. Now, this one is not being used for a gas mask. I'm actually using it to store my water canteen. So it's pretty easily that it has the zippers. You can just pull it out and put it back in easily again. So I don't even have to hassle myself here with the buckles and everything. And since it's water, if the bottle's filled up, it's going to be heavy. I'd rather have this on the back of the belt so it's not dragging down to the left or to the right. So it's more for a center balance. Next pouch you'll probably recognize if you watched my latest video, which was a Flora Medic pouch detailed review. And I definitely think you should check that out if you want to know more of the contents inside and what's actually inside. But as you can see here, just a quick look at it. It has Velcro and this buttoning system here. So nothing too new here, you've probably seen it, and if you haven't, check out that video. Next here is my sidearm. So we'll start with the holster. The holster is made from Predator Gear Inc., which is a Danish company that makes custom orders and just standard holsters for most sidearms that you see nowadays. And the sidearm that's in here is a ASG Glock 19. With an X300 weapon light, which is a replica, so it's not real, but it still works very good. Now, Glock 19s are probably not the most common pistol in use by FSP. I think I've seen them definitely much more with Glock 17s, but I'm not running a direct impression, so it's just inspired, so I definitely think it works out. Like I said, I'm a right-hand shooter, so my drawing side is on the right side, so that's why the holster is there. Last but not least, nothing spectacular here, just a quick little smart thing I do for myself. If you're running gloves, you'll probably know that sometimes it can be a bit annoying to just quickly secure them without losing them. You can put them in pouches, but sometimes you just put the left one and forgot where the other one is. To reduce this and not to drop my gloves, which I really like, I just put on a carabiner hook on this belt here, so it's secured. And I have the belt loops, or the kind of strap cords here to the gloves, secured in the carabiner. So if I have to get them quick, I can just do it like this. And I have them. And if I need to put them back on, just do the same. Pretty easy. So it's just a smart... Also, I just have this whole carabiner because you never know if you need to put something here. Just maybe chem lights or whatever. Something running on your belt. It's pretty easy. Alright guys, so that was a pretty quick but hopefully informative review or detailed look at my belt setup. Not to forget, of course, the belt itself is from Anna, which is ANA, which is a Russian manufacturer of both uniforms, tactical gear and other. And they definitely see use. So I think it's pretty price-worthy products. A lot of people prefer to use JTEC, since that's what's definitely seeing most use now. I'm not very much into those kind of details. As long as I have something I've seen in use and that I feel is practical myself, I'll use it. But hopefully you like this video. Let me know what you guys think. Do you run a similar setup? Can you show me pictures? Maybe link to an Instagram account or whatever. I'll definitely be happy to check it out. Make sure to leave a like, a comment, and of course, subscribe if you aren't already. Thank you very much for watching this video. Until next time, Joker out.